This is part six of adding and subtracting rational expressions that have different denominators. All right, we're going to do a doozy here. It's kind of a long problem. You'll be having three fractions to deal with, and it takes a lot more space. So if you're doing this with me, you might want to get a big piece of paper out and turn the page sideways so you have plenty of room to write. So we're going to begin by making sure we factor all the denominators. So for this first one, I have an x plus 1, and notice all I have is a 1 minus 2x, right? Well, when the highest degree, which is the x term here, is negative, I usually factor out a negative 1, 2x minus 1. And you'll see in a minute why that probably is a good idea. All right, let's go on to the next one, minus. Oh, actually, we want to leave a little space in case we have to multiply that by something, right? Let's go on to the next one now. Minus, I've got an x plus 3. I'm going to put that in parentheses. And in fact, this first one, I'm going to put the x plus 1 in parentheses as well. Since if we multiply it by something, we want to remember that's a whole quantity. Over 4x minus 3. And we might have to multiply that by something. And then you know what? I'm running out of room. I'm going to have to write the second one down. Minus 9 minus 7x minus 10x squared. And I'm going to factor that denominator. So this is the only one that I really had to factor. And let's see. You could do that on scratch paper if you want. Let's see, I think that's a 4x and a 2x. And I think it's a 1 and a 3. Both going to be minus. See if that works. That gives you a negative 4x and a negative 6x. All right, you might not be able to factor quite as quickly as I can, but I'll give you a hint. Notice these two factors here, 4x minus 3 and 2x minus 1. You might want to just see if that happens to be the correct factors for trial factors. All right, so I've got that. So you have to look at all three of these denominators, and it looks like the least common denominator is 4x minus 3 times 2x minus 1. All right, so the trick is I've got this negative 1 here, right? I'm going to have to deal with that, and I can do that by multiplying the top and bottom by negative 1. That way, when I multiply this negative 1 times that negative 1, I'll have just 2x minus 1. But I also need a 4x minus 3. I said this was challenging, right? Okay, and for the next one, I need a 2x minus 1. Don't know why that looks so bad. All right. So now what we need to do is multiply the numerators of each, right? Each fraction. So this is tricky. I've got a negative 1 times an x plus 1 times a 4x minus 3. So I'm going to leave that negative 1 out in front for now. And I'm going to do x minus 1 times 4x minus 3, which is 4x squared. I'm going to have a minus 3x, a plus 4x, and a minus 3. That's the first numerator. And for the second one, I'm going to have to minus and put in parentheses x plus 3 times 2x minus 1 is a 2x squared, a minus x, a plus 6x, and a minus 3, right? And I'm just doing the numerator just because I'm going to run out of space here. And then for the last numerator, I'm just going to distribute that minus sign. It's going to be minus, in fact, I'll just keep that in there, minus 9 minus 7x minus 10x squared. So let's just simplify the numerator before we do anything more. It's going to be a negative, all right, negative 4x squared, right, this equals a plus 3x, and actually, let's simplify inside the parentheses. This gives you plus x, the negative 3x plus 4x, so the opposite that will be minus x. Okay, so that's plus x, so when I distribute the 1, it's a minus x, and then I'm going to have a plus 3. Distribute your minus sign here, minus 2x squared. Again, inside, that's going to give you a 5x, so when I distribute the minus sign, it's a minus 5x, and then minus a negative 3 would be plus 3. And the last one, we're going to have to subtract the 9, add 7x, plus 10x squared. So we're still just simplifying this numerator, right? All right, now let's add like terms. So we have 10x squared minus 2x squared minus 4x squared. So what is that? 4x squared. So I've taken care of the x squared terms. All right, now for the x terms, I've got a negative x, a negative 5x, and a plus 7x. So that's going to give you plus 1x. And for my constants, I've got 3 plus 3 minus 9. So 6 minus 9 is negative 3. So wow, that's just the numerator. Okay, now let's go back and remember what the denominator was. The denominator was the 4x minus 3 times 2x minus 1. So this whole thing is going to be over 4x minus 3 over 2x minus 1, correct? Let me look up here. 4x minus 3, 2x minus 1. So the whole answer here is 4x squared plus x minus 3 all over 4x minus 3 times 2x minus 1. And then we have to see if we can factor that further and cancel. Okay, so let's see. So this is what we have so far from above. Now, can we factor? Well, I'm going to guess that I can factor a 4x minus 3. I'm just going to try. Trial factors here. That would have to be an x and a minus 1. Does that work? I mean, it'd have to be a plus 1, right, to get negative 3. So this would give you plus 4x and minus 3x. Gives you the right middle term. Gives you the right first and last term. Good. So it did factor into 4x minus 3 times x plus 1. The bottom was a 4x minus 3 times 2x plus 1. I'm sorry, 2x minus 1. This is exhausting. We can cancel those. So finally, we get x plus 1 over 2x minus 1. Wow, quite a problem. So, of course, you kind of need a big piece of paper. Doing this on a video, I just can't, you know, put the paper sideways, so sorry it took so much space. But here it all is. We started off with this problem. Okay? And then I took my time simplifying the numerator here, as opposed to keep trying to write it with the denominator. So that's one technique, just kind of figure out your numerator and then go back once you've done it and write it over the denominator. Remember to factor, see if anything cancels, and then you hope you didn't make any little errors along the way. It is easy to make, but I double check this and it's correct. So if you could do this one, boy, you're really on the ball. So keep having fun, keep practicing with these.